Hi everyone, this is Praveen Dure from Dice University, and in today's video, we are going to talk about the introduction of Outbrain Native Advertising Traffic Network tutorial. Let's go! Welcome to today's video, everybody. And in today's video, we are going to talk about Outbrain. So Outbrain is actually a discovery in native advertising network. We are going to have a rough introduction on Outbrain and how it works, what is the pros of Outbrains, what is the cons of Outbrains, and all this kind of stuff in today's video. But before that, before we proceed further regarding the Outbrain, like I told you earlier, the Outbrain is actually a native advertisement. So what is actually a native ad? That's a question that we should answer even before we go and talk about native advertisement network, right? So the native ads is actually the concept of creating ads which is so creative and so comprehensive with the page content that it can actually assimilate into the design of the website, or what we say as blending into the website itself. And what happens when the content is actually blending within the ad is actually blending within the content is that the viewer actually feels that the ad is really, really a content. And a lot of viewers don't even know that it's actually an ad. It blends in so nicely. So your job as a person who's actually creating a native ads, your job should be concentrating on making your native ads to blend as much as possible. So that should be your major concentration. So basically that is a native ads. I'm going to show you a sample of native ads. As you can see, this is yahoo.com. So over here, these are banner ads over here, and there's like a lot of posts over here, but you can see over here, this is an ad actually. This is a native ad, but it does not look like a native ad, right? Because it's in between the posts and everything looks so much similar with the post. This is an ad, but look, it looks almost similar with the post, but you can actually see it's an ad actually, but it does not look like an ad. It blends in so nicely. And even this one, I will say that it does not blend in that much, but some of the native ads, you should actually see them. You will not believe that they are actually a native ad because they blend in literally that nicely into the website itself that you would not be able to discover whether that's a native ads or not. So these are the sample of native ads. Whatever said and done, like I told you, when you actually try to do a native ads as a beginner affiliate marketer, you must try your best so that the ad actually blend in with the post. Like this one is okay, but this one does not look that great. So this one is actually a little bit okay, but even this one, I won't say that this is a high class native ads. There's a much more performing native ads that really, really blends with the post, guys. So your job as an ad maker is to make the native ads to blend. And that is actually a little bit complicated process when you are actually doing certain stuff. So that's why native ads is actually not for affiliate marketers who are just beginning their journey as an affiliate marketer or a media buyer. This is something that you should take in consideration, because I'm not saying that you as a beginner affiliate marketer or beginner media buyer could not go into the native ads, but I'm saying that there's different alternatives for you to start. Definitely there's push, there's pop under, which you can actually go ahead and try first before coming into the native ads. So you will have a rough understanding on how these ads works, how these ad networks works, and all this kind of stuff before you get into the complication of the creative. I'm exaggerating things too much. It's not that complicated, but like I told you, as a beginner affiliate marketer, I would highly suggest you to go into other ad formats first before you come into native ads. But try to learn about native ads, because native ads is really, really powerful. So coming back to our topic, which is the Outbrain, guys. So let's talk about Outbrain now. We have already talked about native ads, so let's talk about Outbrain. So Outbrain was established, I'm not sure, year 2006 or 2005, but it was really, really long time ago. So the Outbrain, like I told you, it's a native advertising network that partners with CNN, Bloomberg, and other publishers to connect them with advertisers. So advertisers like us, usually we use Outbrain to show ads that mimic editorial stories, and when somebody actually clicks on the ad, we actually pay for it. So that's how it works. And Outbrain shares the revenue from the advertiser with the publisher. So that's the whole thing that Outbrain does. So what is the pros and cons of Outbrain? Let's go ahead and cover that up. So when we talk about the pros of Outbrain, Outbrain has few pros. So one of the main pros of Outbrain is that it has access to CNN, Time, ESPN, and many more high-rated publishers. And that's a huge, huge pro over there, guys. And when you talk about cost efficiency, Outbrain is really, really cost-effective. And that is also considered as one of the Outbrain's pros. And also, when you go ahead and see the dashboard of Outbrain, which we are going to take a look at later on, you will see that it's actually very, very simple to use. And there's also multiple conversion pixel events which you can actually put within Outbrain as well. So these are the things that I personally feel which is the pros and the pros of Outbrain personally. And you can also start Outbrain as a little of $10, guys. So the barrier is actually very, very low. And what about the cons of Outbrain? We have already talked about the good stuff about Outbrain. Let's talk about the bad stuff of Outbrain. When you come to Outbrain, Outbrain does not have a self-serve whitelist. I personally, for those who likes to use whitelist and blacklist, native ads really, really, it's very important for you to utilize this whitelist and blacklist. Not like push, where you can utilize it or not utilizing it does not make any big difference. But when it comes to native ads, utilizing the whitelist and blacklist is very important. And that's one of the biggest drawback of Outbrain. And also with Outbrain, you may need an account management assistant when you are doing high volume. When you're doing low volume, you won't be needing it. But when you're doing high volume traffic, you might be needing an account management assistant. And also to get access to Outbrain in the beginning, it's really, really hard. So that's why I always tell, if you're a beginner affiliate marketer and then you want to get access to all these kind of ad networks like Outbrain, it's really, really hard, guys. So that's something that you should consider. And keep in mind that Outbrain is one of the more difficult ad network to get your creative and landing page approved as well. So they are very strict in this kind of term. So you need to have a very good experience when you want to go ahead and use the Outbrain. So the minimum budget for a campaign with Outbrain is $10 or $300 per month, and the minimum CPC is 3 cents. So that's something that you should always keep in mind. But when I say 3 cents, that's a minimum, but don't expect it to be 3 cents, guys. Yeah, so you have to keep that in mind as well. So when you always use Facebook or Google, you advertise on them, right? So Outbrain is actually very, very similar to Facebook. And it's I will say that it's one of the alternatives available for Facebook there as well. And like I told you, just keep in mind that Outbrain is very, very strict when it comes to the creative. So make sure you are really, really tip-top over there. So this is how the dashboard of Outbrain looks like. So you can actually see a lot of stuff with Outbrain. And also, they are actually based in United States of America. So they cater both for advertisers as well as publishers as well. So when you hit the register button, you can actually go ahead and register your account with the Outbrain Amplify. Like I told you, it might get a little bit trickier to get accepted, especially if you're a beginner. And then once you're in, this is how the dashboard of Outbrain looks like. So it's a pretty original dashboard. So you can actually see over here, everything looks pretty original. So this is like campaign, this is like conversion, there's like audience, schedule reports, and payments. So we can actually go ahead and add campaign over here. And when you hit the add campaign, no, we're gonna start new campaign. So this is how it looks like. So basically, these are the system. Let me just show you guys. So let me just name the campaign test very fast. So I'm just going to go show you traffic. So there's also the carousel format, which is a new format for native. So you can actually adjust your budget, your scheduling. There's also targeting. So let's target United States, for example. Location. United States. Okay, United States, for example. So you can have advanced audience targeting, interest targeting over here, which is very similar with Facebook, placement targeting and all this kind of stuff. So this is for your tracking. So once you have done all that, then you can go to the content section where you can actually go ahead and create your content. This is where you put your content's URL. Then this is where you put the image, and this is where you put the title as well as your site name. So like I told you, it might be a little bit complicated the first time you look at it, but then when you enter the dashboard and you start doing it, it will not be that complicated. But you have to keep in mind that native ads, it's not considered as usually beginner friendly. So basically that's about it, guys, in today's video. And I think I've covered a lot in today's video regarding the Outbrain ad network, and I really hope that you enjoyed today's video. And on top of that, I really hope that you benefit from today's video. Thanks again for watching, everybody. I'll be seeing you in the next one. But before I go,
allow me to introduce the Dice University Forum. Whether you are trying to make your first conversion on ClickBank or scale your campaigns to six figures, the Dice University Forum offers you exactly what you need, like high quality landing page templates, detailed case studies, and exclusive discounts. The forum has no outdated information. All resources inside are from campaigns that are running right now. Do you want to learn from super affiliates? Check the link in the description and sign up today.